Hi, Tech Rabbit here. We can continue building the 3D printer. Now we're going to tackle the y-axis assembling the belt. So let's see what we can do. So here we go. Now then, what do we need for this? So if we look at the parts list, we need some printed parts, which is the Y-belt holder, smaller one, which is that one, and then we need a larger one, it's that part, and then we need a belt, so it's there, the belt. Focus, thank you. It's a bit tricky for the camera now. It's so high up. And then we need some screws. We need M330. And then we need an M3 × 10. Four of them. And then we need the M3 N, small N, large N, Nylock nut one, and then we need a normal M3N nut. Two. So I tried to like collect them all in there. So that's the port. So this might be a bit tricky, so let's see. Now we need to take one of the smaller ports. Move that out of the way for a while. Maybe. A little bit more workspace. And it might actually be a good idea to have the mini cam here also. So we can get a better picture of what's going on. So anyway, let's take that on. And then let's see. Okay, so that just takes a normal nut. Where's this nut? Need to insert it. This and that needs to go in there. So like that. Oh, that's good enough. It's always difficult filming black parts. Okay, and then we have take the same part, and then we need to nylon nut. So that's that one, and then it needs to go in. So that's the port that needs to go in. In like that, into the hole. Oops, I might need to get some help for that. Use the pulling trick. So, pull it in there. Now it's nicely embedded in there. So now it should be according to the assembly picture. Okay. Try and make this smaller. So we'll make the picture bigger. Take that much real estate, mate. Okay, so then the next step is to actually open the belt. This needs to be if I do it the same way the picture is, it's much more difficult to put it. Starting to be okay. Wait, I need to. I think I actually have to borrow battery to put this a bit higher up. So I can actually see it. So that's the way it looks. So if I stand it up the way they had it in the picture, then it should look like that. So the belt is circled around it, man. Try and screw that in. Oops, wrong bit. Have a bit. Is it this one? Yeah. Change. So. Now we should be careful when we tighten this, not to over tighten it, so we don't crush the belt. I should probably pull up the belt a bit just to see that it's actually positioned correctly. So I think that's okay. And then we can see from the other side, one can see that it's actually coming through. Just, yeah, that's screwed in enough. And it's not crushing the belt too much. So. Okay, well, I suppose we have to say we're... No, I made a mistake. Yes, of course. Classical mistake. So the belt's the wrong way around.
Ash.
Too many angles. Oh, no, we take it out and do it right.
Ah, such a pity.
Just got it into place.
Always, yeah, I tried to do things too fast.
Always orientate everything according to the instructions in the picture, otherwise one will not get things right. So, it should be like that, and it should go around like that. And the screw goes in there like that. So, it's actually harder to put in this way around. Get in there. Why couldn't I just put it that way? Still not happy. Surprisingly hard to get in. So anyway, this is how it's supposed to go. So I just screw it in and check that it's... No, it's not good. Okay, the nut came a bit out, so... Not slipped out of it. I'm not, still not happy with that. I'll help it down in there a bit. Why does that not want to go in even though? Like these belts to be even. Did I get it now? Yes, now. Okay, so what a mess. But anyway. That's how it looks. Some light on. So the belt edge needs to be up. The edged bit. With the screw in like that. It was actually much more difficult to get in this way. And then you have the screw. But anyway, okay. So. Orientate things according to the instructions. Otherwise one is going to not get it correct. It did say it in the instructions. Here. These arrows. totally my fault. Okay. I hope we have it now. And that's from that angle. Yeah. So now it looks exactly like in the picture. And this is gonna be the most difficult part. Well, if I fully understand the instructions, we're going to, because now we need to put the belt actually on the machine, and then understand what angle. What end are they talking about? Let's see. I think they have it laid like this. So I think I'll put back here. That's the pulley end. Okay, now I have to try and position so I can actually show what should be, and that should be a M310 screw. That's one of those. And I would like to position the mini camera so we can actually see. Nope, not that one. That one again. Okay, here's the pulley, and then we need to put it there. And let's see. And the belt needs to go like that, there, with this screw. So let's try and do that. Okay. Just read the instructions to make sure I'm actually gonna putting this on the right side, double confirming. Ah, printed parts, always a little bit of tolerance. So if you move that back to try and access the screw, it's not that easy. No, it's not going to be that easy to access. Hard to screw. It's always going to end up in a bit of an angle. See if we can get it in. So before tightening it, we need to make sure that it looks like it's in line. Somewhat at least. Oh, how can one tell that? What is the line? So if one lines it up against the bottom here. Black against black. It is so difficult to see. Okay, so let's say that is good enough. Back to the screw. Oh, it moved. That's the 3D printed parts are slippery. So, back to checking again. Was I lucky enough? Yeah, it went back to where it was supposed to. So, let's see now. So, that's the way that's supposed to be on. Okay. And then, we're supposed to... Let's see if I can get a picture, get a video of that without getting too much light in the camera. Yeah, that's pretty good. Hard to have space for the instructions while I'm working on this, and my table isn't that big. Okay, just thinking maybe I should just take only the mini cam for this one. Because now one comes from here, and then one has to come over here, thread it around the motor, and then one comes back, and then one should go around the pulley, which is around here. So, like that. I think that was a good visualization. And then, we need to put the belt on the holder. Okay, so now we need to take the other, oops, that one, and it sits around. Okay, we put the nut in there. Suggestion was to use the pulling technique again. So insert the, we use the long screw. And we actually just put the nut on that. Oops. Well, that is a bit hard to get in. Just a sec. This printed part. To have my pliers using these, because this doesn't want to go in that hole, so I have to try and pull it. Hope I don't break anything. Nope. that one didn't fire. So there. Oh. So that's the pulling technique. So use the pliers and pull that through. But it was quite tough to get in. Let's see, nothing broken. No, looks still okay. So that's that. And then the next phase. And again, one needs to look at the belt ends up the right way around. So that should go like that. And then somehow one should. This is the problem. The picture is one way around and the whole printer assembly is the other way around, so. Okay, now I understand why it's so confusing. Oh, I'm using the Minic, of course. Okay, so that's actually going to end up like that. Now, wait. So this here, this part is going to end up like that in there, and the so this needs to be bent. Too precise. Screw. Oh, my hands are just blocking everything. Well, I will try and show this once. I really need all hands on deck just to get this in place. Easiest thing to get in place, that's for sure. Now everything fell off again. So that's going to go on there like that. This is going to go around, not that way around. It's going to go around like that. Really don't want to get this screwed up a second time. I think I'm gonna have to pause the video for a while. I'll come back once I got it fiddled in there. Okay, so that wasn't any fun to fix, but anyway, this is the way I would actually recommend do it. Don't screw it onto the first holder onto the printer first. You can very much do this putting on the belts with the belt just looped through the pulley here. And then there's a few details. The jagged edge should be on the inside of the loop. So I was doing a little bit of a screw up before. And also the other end of the belt, when it loops around, it shouldn't come outside of the area of the printed part. So it shouldn't extrude out of the hole, so I've corrected that also. So now everything should be okay. So now we can put back the let's see if I can get a good angle here. Let's see now. So now we're coming back to this, so that will go. I think the one should, I mean, I do understand why they made the instruction, because they want people to have the orientation correctly, but I must say, from an installation perspective, it's not the absolute optimal. But I can forgive that and just come up with my own instruction. To see. Might take another screw. Oh, that went in okay. Well, what was the? Why was it not going in correctly? Strange. It's this. Aluminium parts, one has to be a bit careful, one doesn't strip the threads. So now I think it started going okay. I don't know what happened there. Time. I don't intend to censor out screw-ups that I make, because I think it's actually important to leave them in, because somebody actually might do the same mistakes, and then actually if they watch the video first, then maybe they can actually avoid having problems. No, I think I'm actually going to leave that belt, because this will just be hanging, so I can actually just screw this on. And this screw shouldn't be tightened too much, because we're going to have to adjust the tension of the belt. Sliding. But as you see, if the belt isn't free, then it's going to be an absolute nightmare to put anything on. Just loosen that up. Sorry for the movement of the camera, but I need to get it back here. Now we should be able to put that around that pulley. Just going to have enough freedom. Or were they right? I like to be right.
No, come on. Give me a break.
Let's see if I can still get it. Maybe it's the instructions are correct. You need to put it around the pulley before.
Yeah. Okay.
But how am I going to get that screw on? It's going to be a bit of a mystery. Ah, but it's going to be loose, of course, because it's going to go around the pulley. So, now it's around the pulley. And then we'll come back with this. So I still have the screw in it. So, and that was not supposed to be super tight, so let's see if that can still move. Yeah, that will still. Maybe loosen it just a little tiny bit. Let's see. I don't like it too loose, but it should be loose enough so that one can actually adjust the belt. Too much light here. Should reduce the lighting of it. And then one can't see the black parts. Okay, so double check with picture, I suppose. See if we can understand what they mean by this whole thing. Use the right ball. It's going to be. That's going to go through there. So that's the set, and it's supposed to come over the edge here. I hope you can see it. It protrudes into this opening, so that just gives me a bit of an alarm bell. Like, why does it do that? That is according to how it's supposed to be. And then we put the adjustment screw, which we already put the nut in for. And that is a tight fit. Oh. Okay, another... another thing that's not easy to get at. Sunshine here. It makes filming a bit difficult. Hard to get a... And if I angle it so you can see the... See it, then it's, gets blinded. Oh, the nuts coming out. Rat, I didn't hold it. Darn. Okay. Have to just screw it through so we can try and get the nut on it again. Doing something a bit simpler than this next. I wonder if it would actually help if I reduce my lighting a bit. Let's see. Does the camera like it better if it doesn't have so much light? Ah, still grainy. It's probably all the black ports. No, I think I'm going to have to pause the video and to get the nut back on again. Wait, can you see it? It's supposed to go in there. Wire and wire. Supposed to be the nut that we put in there. It needs to go back on. I'll pause and come back once I fill that in. Okay, so that's the belt in place. Maybe we should take one final look at it. Just go ahead and move the camera so I can come over here. That's what it looks like on the top. So now we have to take that one instead. Because now what we have to do is we have to align the belt to make it run. Whoa, that's actually not that bad. I suppose we can see it a bit. No, wait, we need to look in here. Oh, wait. It's already inclined. Oh, it is offline. So if one looks in here, then one can see that it's not... The top belt should run in the same line as the bottom belt. So I have to... So the way you do it is that we loosen up that. We loosen up that. Try and find out what's the best position for this. Oh, that can actually move a lot more. Let's see. It's looking pretty good. But if one wants it to run more in the middle of the spin ball. I suppose one could just move it a little bit more. I mean, I don't know if it's possible to get absolutely perfect, but I think we call that a day. Yeah, I think we say that that's good enough for now. Can always adjust it later. Is a bit to the right of the side, but it seems to want to adjust itself. There's the belt, I mean, so I suppose we just have to say that that's good enough. So now it's the belt tension. This, I suppose. Move that down. And let's see what it said about tensioning the belt. Using the finger left on your left hand, push the belt down. Some force should be needed to. Okay, so it's still doing it from the top. Okay, so one should actually have it like this. And one should do it on the spindle side. Right there. You should push down. I don't know why one should use one's left hand specifically. Should be needed to bend in the ball. But don't overstretch the belts, it might damage the printer. Some force should be needed. I love this. Like, yeah. A bit of a subjective view, I would say. But based on my previous experience with printers, I would say, we could tighten it up maybe just a little tiny bit. So when you want to tighten it, turn that around like that. Push it up here, maybe I can see that. And then the tightening screw is there. And then we just take the screwdriver, or the hex thing, and then we just tighten it up a bit. So I think that'll be good enough. I mean, when I hold the belt, there's no flex really. So if one holds the I think I'll do this test. So if we put it in the middle, I hold the spindle, and then I try and move the center part up and down. It pretty much acts on the motor immediately. I'd say we have it good enough. That. So, that's the belt in place, I would say. Have we missed anything? It was the that one done. So, it's just the beginning of the next episode. Okay, well, that was maybe not super fun, but at least it's done. If you like this video, consider subscribing. If you just thought it a little bit interesting and you know somebody struggling to build this type of printer, then please share. Press the like button if you liked it. And I will see you in the next one.